Here's my Honda Aero 50 in the dark. So I guess you can't really see it that well. Anyhow, taking a night ride to drop off some mail. Haven't ridden this thing for a while. But don't you love how it just starts right up on the first push? That's right, electric start. Ease it on out the driveway between the house and the car. There's my mail. Someone just bought some light bulbs for me, headlight bulbs. I sell stuff on eBay to support my moped addiction. Okay, we skipped ahead in time to get to a little more well-lit area. Just kind of warming it up, nice and gentle-like. I put a new carburetor on this. Like my Urban Express, the damn carburetor was leaking. And I found out that you could buy an aftermarket carb on eBay for like 19 bones. Time to drop off the mail. It's like a half mile ride to the mail launch of my house. Now let's go back home. I discovered that a while back anyways that there's actually a metal detector that activates the light. You can see it built into the road. You need to get right over one of those metal rails to set it off, and sometimes these damn things never don't set it off. Wait a minute, I'm not heading home. I'm taking a detour. Anyhow, yeah, I put a new carb on it and adjusted it. It's probably running a tad bit rich, but running pretty well overall. What else did I do? New spark plug. Needed a new speedometer cable. My buddy painted up some of the panels for me. I got a new drive belt for it, but I haven't put that on. Overall, I haven't had to do really too much to it. This thing's probably the most reliable and most practical bike for everyday commuting. It's got nice acceleration. It's got a good top speed of about 38 miles per hour right now. And, you know, you can feel comfortable tooling around in traffic. Still got the oil injector system working on it. Got the vacuum operated petcock, so you don't have to,
this guy's got like,
oh yeah, I am suddenly surprised by a guy on a bike, because I can hardly see him, he's got those light strips on his rims, but if you come up like straight behind him, I couldn't hardly see him at all. So I try to give him a little friendly advice.
How's it going?
Good, you?
Good. You need like a rear light, man. You're hard to see.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, you got the side, but from the back, I almost came right up on you.
Okay.
But anyhow.
All right. I mean, yeah. I put these on thinking it would help, but
you need something in the back.
It doesn't point out back very well.
I was like, I slammed on the brakes as I was coming right up on you, and I finally saw you. I was like, whoa.
Shoot. Okay.
All right, take it easy.
Of course, you can see him a little better now under the light. Trying to help a brother out, man. Just trying to help you out, brother. If I didn't see you, some guy, some old lady or old man in a car, I may not see you until it's too late. Of course, it makes me wonder how visible I am on this thing. People look for cars. If they don't see a car, they don't see a motorcycle. Expectations. Looking for a car and a motorcycle's coming. No car's coming, so nobody's coming. Take a detour up here, but I end up editing all that out because it's too dark. Now I'll talk a little bit about what to look for when you're buying one of these or any of these. Scooters or no-heads or mopeds. Generally, you should always bring a light with you so you can look inside the gas tank. A lot of these things are over 30 years old. They've got a metal gas tank that there's usually issues with it. The brakes are usually a problem, but that's an easy fix. You know, I guess my rule of thumb is if you see something wrong, if you see one thing wrong, there's probably two or three other things you don't see that are wrong as well. So you can call that the two or three multiplier. So the gas tank, the brakes. Probably just don't run. There's probably a little something wrong with how they run. But usually it's the carburetor, just needs a good cleaning. The tires are usually dry rotted out, although the tires on this were great, so I changed them at some point recently. But for the most part, you're going to have issues with the tires. Usually a good idea to replace the rim strip, the tube, and the tire. So we're going to check the gas tank. Yeah. Sometimes you have to buy a used replacement gas tank. The brakes, the tires. I've ridden a couple of them with bent forks. People will wreck them. That's the other big thing is, you know, mirror will be broken off, or turn signal will be broken off, front fender will be damaged, foot pegs will be bent or broken, the forks will be bent if they get hit hard enough. So it's not uncommon for them to have been in some type of a wreck. Got to deal with that. I've got a QT50 with bent forks now. Foot pegs were broken. You couldn't tell because they were like foot pegs covers that were covering them when they were broken. But it's just my rule. You know, I realized the forks were bent, negotiated the price down as a result. And then, the rule, if you see something that's wrong, might be one or two other things that are wrong as well, or maybe even three other things. And the other thing that was hidden were the foot pegs were two spots. I guess that's two other things. They were bent as well. So those are some things to look for if you're out shopping on Craigslist for one of these. You can tell the forks are bent because it'll want to pull one direction or the other. So if you just lighten your grip on the handlebars and ride it, you'll feel it pull one way or the other. Now luckily for me, the front tire was low on air, but I filled it up with air. Didn't pull as bad. You can still feel it, but that's on my other, the QT50. You can still feel it, but it's not as bad. But I ended up finding some replacement forks on eBay for a decent price. I'm going to try swapping those out. So those are a few things to look for. You can also look for, you know, how was the bike generally maintained, or how was it stored. A lot of times they've just been sitting for years and years. People will leave gas in the tank, and gas has water in it. Water rusts metal. So over time, you know, that's going to be, that's why the gas tank is usually a problem. I hit like 40 down a slight hill here somewhere. You can hear the engine pitch get a little bit higher when that happens. Check the headlight, low and high beams, see if they work. You know, sometimes, you know, the seller will just say, oh, it just needs a new bulb. Well, why didn't you change it? It ends up being a wiring issue that you have to chase down and spend hours on. So it's awfully nice when you get something like this where all the lights work. That's a big plus. It can save you a lot of headaches. One head tight. That's all this was. So anyways, enjoy the rest of the ride. I did.